Okay, we are back with some more Melanie Martinez. Next up is Detention, and we got a video produced by Michael Keenan. All right, man, let's check it out. Is that a marimba? What is he doing? Oh, I thought he was trying to... Okay. Pretty quiet. Oh shit, what the fuck? Let me just, I feel like the whole first verse I didn't really pick up on. I'm not a bad guy, so don't treat me bad if I'm feeling sad, alright? Please don't be mad if I don't smile back. If I fuck up my words, don't think I'm absurd, alright? Okay. I'm physically exhausted, tired of my knuckles beaten. Chewing gum the past of time, can you see it? You're too busy seeking selfish wishes. Don't care how I'm feeling. Think it's love. So, it sounds like her partner maybe is keeping her, like... not in detention, but more like a metaphor, keeping her at a distance or kind of punishing her if she's not reciprocating just because she might not be having a good day, perhaps. His smile. That guy's funny, dude. Okay. Like the record label, the teachers. Whatever they want to me, they're the customer who shot me. Seems like it. I'm physically exhausted, tired of my knuckles beating. I'm chewing gum to pass this time of sadness. Can't you see it? You're too busy seeking selfish wishes. Look at how I'm feeling. It's like a flip book. That's cool. The water drop. Interesting. I don't think it's about a partner at all now, because like once we heard about the teachers and stuff, it really just seems like it's more about like a record label taking advantage of their artists and making them work overtime. Who was the one artist they had, like, I mean, a lot of artists deal with this where it's like they're in a contract that they don't like, but they're forced to make like four albums over like a year or 2 years or something like that. And I forget what artist it was, but they just put out an album that they didn't even care about. It might have been Doja Cat. It could have been Logic. I forget. But they just put out albums for the sake of like getting out of that contract, and they didn't put like a lot of effort into it. You know, they'd make something, and they just don't put their heart into it because they just want to get out of the contract. That's kind of what it's giving. Not that this, I'm not just how labels are. Oh shit. That synth is sick. The water droplet sound effect. I love that. What's going on with that teacher? Wow, okay, creepy, interesting. The videos all connect though, and we're not watching them in order, so it's kind of like we're missing context and stuff. She literally has the voice that everybody wants. Melanie, okay, that's a lot. Classic comment though. I love how she's ending this era and making every thumbnail RIP crybaby. Interesting. Emojis. I love how her albums are growing and finding out what she is like. Her first album, Crybaby, was like a childish pastel color goth kind of thing. Crybaby was also about things kids go through. Now K-12 is about school things and kids and teens go through. And her next album will be darker. There's a progression there. One thing about Melanie is that she'll never let you down. I absolutely love how carefully crafted her projects are. Okay, so we're all ignoring how amazing Melanie's hair looks here. Everyone's talking about how pretty Melanie is, but those two girls dancing with her are really pretty too. Her songs have a very blatant social commentary, which she portrays through these colorful sets and actors wearing colorful clothes. This is because that's how the world is always shown, and the idea of a better world sold to us through media. But nobody notices the harsh, passive reality underlining it. I feel like that's a... No. This is a thing that is when you're a kid, but then that might be what they're talking about, but I don't think... nobody notices. I feel like once you're like, you become a teenager, you slowly start realizing how like dark the world is, and it's not sunshine and butterflies and rainbows. It's not like this happy place. Yes, there's happiness, but the world is a fucking dark place that takes advantage of a lot of people. It's just a sick place, especially the places like Hollywood. Melanie Martinez captures that perfectly through her lyrics, and her voice kind of haunts the lyrics. It's crazy how she sings about these serious topics so casually and uses pastel to turn it to unsettling, honestly. Okay, I can't fucking read today. All right. I think it was a pretty cool song. It wasn't anything super crazy for me. It was nice. The production was kind of cool, though. The low-keyness of the production with the marimba. I love a good marimba classic. The video was nothing super crazy. Nothing super crazy. A little bit of creepiness here and there, as usual. It was nice, man. Keep it elite. I'll keep. What will I rate this one? I'm going to go with like... I'm going to go like an 8.3 on this one. It's a good song. Well made. Good takes. But 8.3 for me, man.